Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the dance between absorption and reflections. We all deal with reflections in our room. It doesn't really matter what the room size and volume and usage is. It's a room. It has boundary surfaces. The energy strikes the surfaces, causes a reflection. So we know what RT60 times are. We've heard this term many, many times. I want you to think about the RT60 time as a summation of all the reflections in the room, their birth, their death, so to speak, and the life between those two points. So attack, decay, it's all of this, energy, subsistence of energy, and the cycle keep repeating itself. But it's really a summation of all the reflections in the room. Now, what we have to understand is that the RT60 is just a measurement that we have to utilize to balance with our usage. So different usages, we have to control the amount of reflections in a different way. We have to lower them and sometimes we have to raise them. What is our treatment of choice? Almost in all the cases, it's absorption. Diffusion is our other option. But let's focus on absorption for now and look at some of the differences in RT60 times that are in the literature. And I have scoured the literature. I have about 100 books that give all kinds of data on past measurements of rooms and stuff. And I took about 20 of those and I synthesized these RT60 times out of those books. So let's take a look at what they're saying. In large concert venues, 1.5 to 2.5 seconds is kind of the range that designers and everybody shoots for. Classroom, 0.4 to 0.8 seconds, RT60 time. Big, big difference. Large venues here, smaller rooms here. The lower the RT60 time, the more emphasis on speech, intelligibility. Because the lower the RT60 time, the more definition we get. So we get to hear speech better, okay? Voice. 0.5 to 0.75 seconds, real close to classroom RT60 times. And then control rooms, 0.75 to 1.25 seconds on the average. Now, I've been in control rooms that are half second. I've been in control rooms that are 3/10 of a second. But it all goes back to usage. If you look at all of these situations here, large concert hall, classroom, voice, control, usage. What are you doing in the room? And once you decide what you're doing in the room, and please don't try to do too many things. Don't try to do voice in a large concert hall. Don't try to do voice in a control room, which a lot of people try to do. Don't try to do voice in a classroom. Because look, the RT60 times are close, but when you're recording voice, the microphone is going to hear more than this numerical difference shows. So usage is critical. These are some ranges of RT60 times that I pulled out of the literature. Your usage, your RT60 time may vary because it's subjective. Everybody's a little bit different, but these are some guidelines and some ranges we can use. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. A room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.